Hello everyone, welcome to Math Cyberspace. This is Dibbendu Gonai and this is our second lecture of Calculus of Variation. In first lecture, we already have learned that what is Calculus of Variation, why we learn Calculus of Variation, what is Euler-Lagrange equation. And now in lecture 2, we are going to learn the another form of Euler-Lagrange equation. How we get this form of Euler-Lagrange equation? Can you tell me when we have to use this form? There are several cases of Euler-Lagrange equation. In this lecture, we are going to discuss everything. Let's start our lecture. In first lecture, we already have seen that the Euler-Lagrange equation is del f del y minus ddx del f del y dash equals to 0. The another form of Euler-Lagrange equation is ddx f minus y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x. This is the another form of Euler-Lagrange equation. Now my first question is, we already have the Euler-Lagrange equation, then why we need this second form of Euler-Lagrange equation? I will discuss on this topic. Before that, let me prove this second form of Euler-Lagrange equation. Proof. We know that the extremizing function f is a function of x, y and y dash. Okay, then what will be df dx? Df dx equals to, by chain rule, del f del x plus del f del y dy dx plus del f del y dash dy dash dx, or df dx equals to del f del x plus del f del y dy dx equals to y dash plus del f del y dash dy dash dx equals to y double dash. We name it as equation number 1. Okay, now what will be ddx of y dash del f del y dash? Now you will ask me why I am calculating this. Why I am calculating df dx, why I am calculating ddx of y dash del f. Actually, I have to prove this form. If I simplify this form, then we get that df dx minus ddx of y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x. This is the simplification form of this another form of Euler-Lagrange equation. That's why first we calculate df dx and now I am calculating this portion. Okay, then ddx of y dash del f del y dash equals to this is of uv formula. Okay, then ddx of y dash, what will be del f del y dash ddx of y dash equals to y double dash plus y dash ddx of del f del y dash. Okay, we name it as equation number 2. Now subtracting 1 by 2, subtracting 1 by 2. Then what we will get if we subtract it? Then df dx minus ddx of y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x plus del f del y dash plus del f del y dash y double dash. This is our df dx minus del f del y dash y double dash, del f del y dash y double dash minus y dash ddx of del f del y dash. Okay, now here del f del y dash y double dash and del f del y we cancelled it out. Okay, now here del f del y dash and minus y dash ddx del f del y dash, we take y dash from out of the bracket, then we get df dx minus ddx y dash del f del y dash equals to this del f del x del f del x plus we taken out y dash, so y dash into del f del y minus y dash ddx of del f del y minus ddx del f del y dash. Okay, ddx del f del y dash. Okay, so this equals to del f del x plus now del f del y minus ddx of del f del y dash. This is our Euler Lagrange equation. Here del f del y minus ddx del f del y dash is equals to 0, so this portion becomes 0, so only del f del x exists. So we get df dx minus ddx of y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x or ddx of f minus minus y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x. This is the another form of Euler Lagrange equation. Okay, now there are some cases where f is, we know that f is a function of x, y, y dash, but there are some cases where f is only function of y and y dash, or f is only function of x and y, or f is only function of x and y dash, or f is only function of y dash. So depending on the independency of the variables of f, depending on the independency of the variable of f, we get some cases of Euler Lagrange equation. Okay, now case one, case one is when f is explicitly independent of x. Explicitly independent of x. Now, what is mean by explicitly independent of x? In this case, f will be function of y and y dash. Here x is not exist, but we know that y is a function of x. That means x exists but not directly. That's why it is called f is explicitly independent of x. Okay. Now what will be the solution for this case? Here f is function of y and y dash, and we know the second form of Euler-Lagrange equation, ddx of f minus y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x. When f is explicitly independent of x, in that case del f del x equals to 0. In that case del f del x equals to 0. So we can put in place of del f del x equals to 0. So ddx of f minus y dash del f del y dash equals to 0. So f minus y dash del f del y dash equals to some constant. This is our solution. Now when I started my lecture, I asked you that why we need the second form of Euler-Lagrange equation. This is our second form of Euler-Lagrange equation. Why we need this second form of Euler-Lagrange equation? Here case 1, we see that f is function of y and y dash, that is explicitly independent of x, and in that case del f del x equals to 0. When we see that some extremizing function is independent of x, we can use this formula. But this is not necessary that when extremizing function is independent of x, we will use this formula. It depends only on you. You have to see that which form is easier to solve the problem. If you see that the Euler-Lagrange equation del f del y minus ddx del f del y dash equals to 0, which is easier than this form, then you have to use that Euler-Lagrange equation del f del y minus ddx del f del y dash equals to 0. It depends only on you. You have to choose which method is easier to you. Okay, let me explain it by an example. This is an example. This is independent of x. Okay, find out the extremal of the functional iy equals to integration 0 to 1 y square y dash square dx, and two boundary conditions are y 0 equals to 0 and y 1 equals to 0. Here the extremizing function f is equals to y square y dash square, and this is explicitly independent of x. That's why del f del x equals to 0. Now we can use the second form of Euler-Lagrange equation, which is ddx f minus y dash del f del y dash equals to del f del x, and del f del x equals to what? 0. So this is equals to 0. Or f minus y dash del f del y dash equals to constant. Now put the value of f, or y square y dash square minus y dash del f del s del f del y dash equals to 2 y square y dash. 2 y square y dash equals to constant. We take it as c. Okay, or this is 2 y square y dash square. So if we simplify this, we get minus y square y dash square equals to c, or y square y dash square equals to c1 square, where c1 square equals to minus c. As it is constant, so we may choose it this constant. Okay, so y square y dashed square equals to c1 square. So y dashed equals to plus minus c1, or y dashed equals to c1 by y. We take only the positive sign. So dy dx equals to c1 by y, or y dy equals to c1 dx. So y square by 2, if we integrate this, y square by 2 equals to c1x plus c2. This is our solution. Now you put the boundary condition y0 equals to 0 and y1 equals to 1, then you will get the yx. Okay, let me do it. If y0 equals to 0, then c2 equals to 0 and y1 equals to 1, this implies c1 equals to half. So y square by 2 equals to c1 equals to half, so x by 2. So y square equals to x. This is our extremal. Okay. So when f is explicitly independent of x, in that case we can use the second form of Euler-Lagrange equation. Okay. Now case 2. Case 2 is when f is independent of y. Independent of y. That is, f is function of only x and y dash. When f is independent of y, in that case, del f del y equals to 0. We know the Euler-Lagrange equation, del f del y minus ddx of del f del y dash equals to 0. Now here del f del y equals to 0, so this portion will be 0. So ddx of del f del y dash equals to 0. If we integrate this, we get del f del y dash equals to constant. Okay, now this is our solution. If we put the value of f and the value of del f del y dash, then we can get the extrema. Let me explain it by an example. Here, independent of y, the question is, find the extremal of the functional f is equals to y dashed square plus x square dx, and two boundary conditions are given. Here f is equals to what? F is equals to y dashed square plus x square. Now here f is independent of y. So del f del y equals to 0. Now we already seen that del f, in that case del f del y dash equals to constant. We take it as c1. So what is del f del y dash? Del f del y dash equals to 2y dash equals to c1. So y dash equals to, we take it c2, where c2 equals to c1 by 2. So dy dx equals to c2. So y equals to c2x plus c3. This is our extremal. Now if we use the boundary condition y0 equals to minus 1 and y1 equals to 1, we can solve the problem and we can get the extremal. Okay. Now we go to the case 3. Case 3. In case 3, we take f is independent of y dash. Okay, when f is, that means f is a function of x and y, and when f is independent of y dash, in that case del f del y dash equals to 0. Now what is our Euler-Lagrange equation? Del f del y minus d dx del f del y dash equals to 0. Now here del f del y dash equals to 0, so again we have to write it case 3 independent of y dash, and del f del y dash equals to 0. That means f is a function of x and y. Okay, and we know the Euler-Lagrange equation, del f del y minus d dx del f del y dash equals to 0, and here del f del y dash is equals to 0, so this is 0 only, del f del y equals to 0. This is a special case of Euler-Lagrange equation. We will explain this case on the third lecture. Okay, this is a special case. I will explain this on the third lecture. Now case 4. Case 4. When f is independent of both x and y, in case 1 we see that f is independent of x, in case 2 f is independent of y, in case 3 f is independent of y dash. Now in case 4 f is independent of both x and y, that is f is a function of only y dash. And when f is independent of both x and y, then we say that del f del x equals to 0 and del f del y equals to 0. Remember one thing, when f is independent of both x and y, in that case the extremal will be always a straight line. The extremal will be always a straight line. This is an important result. You have to remember it. When f is independent of both x and y, then f is in that case the extremal will be yx equals to c1x plus c2. This is our extremal. This is the equation of a straight line. Now let me explain it by an example. Here, independent of both x and y, the question is find out the extremal iy equals to integration 0 to pi y dash t square dx, and two boundary conditions are y0 equals to 0 and y pi equals to 0. So here f is equals to what? F is equals to y dash t square, which is independent of both x and y, and in that case the extremal will be yx equals to c1x plus c2. Now put the boundary conditions y0 equals to 0. This will give c2 equals to 0, and y pi equals to 0. This will give c1 equals to 0. So yx equals to 0, the trivial solution, is the only solution of this problem. So when both x and y are independent, in that case yx equals to c1x plus c2. Okay, now we already have seen the four cases of Euler-Lagrange equation depending on the independency of the variables of f. Now consider a f, an extremizing function f. Suppose a given f, f is a function of x, y, y dash. Okay, now this f is fixed. Okay, now this extremizing function can give us different type of solutions. Different types of solutions, that means different type of extremal. Different type means maybe unique extremal, maybe infinitely many extremal, maybe there are no solution. What is this? Maybe there are infinitely many solution, maybe no solution, or maybe unique solution. Now why f is fixed? Okay, f is fixed, but we are getting different types of solution. Now what is the reason? Because depending on the different type of boundary conditions. Depending on that, on the different types of boundary conditions, we get the different types of extrema. Let me explain in by an example. This is an example. For the variational, the example is, question is given, for the variational problem I y x equals to integration 0 to 1 y dash t square minus y square dx. Then we have option A, unique solution, option B, infinitely many solutions, option C, no solutions, and option D, exactly two solutions. And there are three boundary conditions given. We have to check every options. Now here, f is equals to y dash t square minus y square. F is equals to y dash t square minus y square. Okay, now the function is independent of x, but I have told you that you have to check which form of Euler Lagrange equation is easier to you. Here the Euler Lagrange equation del f del y minus ddx of del f del y dash equals to 0. This will be easier to solve the problem. Okay, so del f del y equals to del y equals to minus 2y minus ddx of del f del y dash equals to 2y dash equals to 0 minus 2y minus ddx of 2y dash equals to 2y double dash equals to 0, or y double dash plus y equals to 0. This is our differential equation. Now we have to solve this. The auxiliary equation will be m square plus 1 equals to 0. So m equals to plus minus I. In that case, yx equals to c1 cos x plus c2 sin x, where c1 and c2 are arbitrary constants. Now we use the boundary conditions. First boundary condition is y0 equals to 0 and y2 pi equals to 0. When y0 equals to 0, we get c1 equals to 0, and y2 pi equals to 0, again we are getting c1 equals to 0. So the solution is yx equals to c2 sin x. As c2 is arbitrary constant, So we can choose any value of c2. That means here yx can be infinitely many. So for case 1 boundary condition, we are getting the solution option B, infinitely many solutions. Okay. Now, in case second boundary conditions, now second boundary conditions, when y0 equals to 0, we are getting c1 equals to 0 and y pi by 2 equals to 0. In that case, sin pi by 2 equals to 1, so c2 equals to 0. That is yx equals to 0. This is our only solution and this is the trivial solution. Okay, that means yx equals to 0 is the only. So in option 2, we are getting only unique solution. Now we check boundary condition 3. In 3, y0 equals to 0. So c1 equals to 0 and now y pi equals to 1. When y pi equals to 1, cos x cos pi equals to minus 1. So we are getting cos pi equals to, so minus c1 equals to y pi equals to 1. So yx equals to 1. When y pi equals to, we get c1 equals to 0. So this portion cancel out. Y pi equals to 1. So y pi equals to, this is 0. But this portion is 1. So 1 is equals to 0. This is not possible. 1 equals to 0, not possible. So in boundary condition 3, we cannot get any solution. So in that case, option C will be correct. No solution. So we see that we are getting different type of extremal depending on the boundary conditions. Okay. This is enough for today. In the third lecture, I will come with more topic of calculus of variation. We will see another application of Euler-Lagrange equation. Okay. For today, this is enough. If you like my video, then please share with your friends and subscribe our YouTube channel and stay with us. Thank you.